Hello, hello, hello. How is everyone doing? How am I doing? I'm doing all right. I'm doing pretty good. You know, I finished law school. I'm a judge now. Oh, crack open a cold one. You know, if a judge did that, they'd get some like cool guy points for sure. You know, they'd get some respect. The bitrate as of right now is going wild. So hopefully it's going well on everyone else's end. Got really excited because I thought you were playing Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. Hey, that could still happen, just not now. I skipped being the lawyer, and now I'm the judge. That's how it works, right? I graduated from being the lawyer. Now I just sit on my, you know, I sit up where the judge sits. What do they call that? It's the bench. No, the bench is where everyone else goes. I don't know what it's called. I'm sitting up top there, drinking a cold brew. You know, maybe banging the gavel occasionally. But yeah, I'm doing pretty good. Hopefully everyone else is doing well. Is Phoenix Wright even... Oh yeah, there's Phoenix Wright on Steam. I was about to say, like... I swear I've seen it before. A whole trilogy. Man, that'd be like another Persona situation. We just start doing nothing but Phoenix Wright. Hey, it could happen. You never know. I asked Ghost if she wanted to play Festival and she ghosted me. Well, you know, people can be busy. You know, this may come as a shocker, but people could be busy. I would like to think there has been no ghosting, mostly because you're all in the same Discord. I don't think you can be avoided. The Phoenix Wright games are like 20 hours long, if that. Oh, for all three? You're saying I could blast through all three in 20 hours? Whereas Persona is like 120 hours each. Well, I guess that's true, yeah. In comparison, Phoenix Wright games look like, you know, baby mode. You know, baby's first lengthy game. Whereas, yeah, Persona is a straight up, like, RPG. Takes one third of your life. She was playing it. Oh. Yeah, well, maybe. I know the difference is it sounds like you want to do, like, it sounded like you wanted to play, like, a normal mode. So far from what I've heard from Ghost Kitten, she wants to play, like, super ultra hard, get my score up to max, and get on a leaderboard. So you're like playing two different game modes. And personally, I think the first Phoenix Wright is the only one really worth playing. The series is like a downhill slope from the first, but not everyone agrees with that sentiment. Oh yeah, I'm sure there's probably some Phoenix Wright fan that's like, I have so many angry words to say to this person. And just like, If you did that at like a forum or Reddit, you know, you'd get eaten alive or something. Or everyone would agree with you. Who knows? It's always funny on you know, like stepping on eggshells with like super fans. Like, oh, are people really going to take this the wrong way? And then you say it and they're like, oh, no, that's true. Yeah. The other two, they suck. You know, don't play them. or something like that, you know. But yeah, I'm sure she had her reasons. I'm positive. Who knows? I mean, there's no harm in saying, or I'm assuming you meant to say harm. There's no harm in saying no thanks. I mean, who knows? Who knows? She could have been AFK. She could have turned it on, left the game on, and who knows? I dare not assume. That's why I don't post my opinions on fan forums. True. Nobody should go there. Nobody should ever cross that shadowy line. I can't tell you how many Discord messages I don't see. The thing for me is when people direct message me. Like, I've gotten so many private messages via like Twitch, Discord, that it's like, you know, sometimes, yeah, I just don't respond. But no, I know the message that you're talking about. It's the one, yeah, you like posted it in like, I don't know, general talk. But yeah, who knows? I don't know. I'm not gonna assume. Maybe she's busy. Who knows? It's always the fun thing. That's kind of the reason, the other reason why, because I think we talked about this before, where it's like getting other people to play and like inviting randoms or people on stream to join. Like, you don't know what they're doing, you know. They could be fist fighting someone right as we speak. You can ask her when she gets here. You can. I would hope it doesn't turn into some. How come you didn't respond to my message? How come you? This is entrapment. Yeah. She might not have seen the message. You gotta just let it roll off your back. Yes, yes, sent a message. Got no reply. Oh well. I assumed you didn't like the music festival. Because it sounded like you wanted... from what I mean, again, I was like looking at a conversation happening while streaming yesterday. But like, it sounded like you were doing something else. And so you were just coincidentally like, oh, like, okay, let's do music festival. So who knows? Maybe she thinks, you know, well, I don't want to bother him. Sent a message, got no reply. Yeah, that's kind of the thing. Like, hopefully it doesn't turn into some like really awkward, like, how come you didn't respond? Like, you know, it's all good. Speaking of direct messages on Twitch, I think I immediately received one. I received more than just one. Loveth, great. Thank you, thank you. I will read your private Twitch message after the stream. Just in case you're somebody who doesn't want tons of attention on you. I know there's some people that, yeah, they don't like getting shoutouts and stuff. But yeah. Highly appreciate the support. I liked it. Oh, well, that's good. I mean, again, this was like me. This was the outsider looking in on your conversation. Like, it sounded like you were like, ah, I got like a mission. I remember like you had a mission to do or something. I feel like, you know, even explaining it on stream, I sound like I'm like someone's parent watching them play Pokemon or something. Did you catch a Pikachu?
Everything's a Pikachu, right?
Okay, if it's just on my end, but the stream is really choppy for me. How's your bitrate? It's starting to level out, but admittedly, it was really crunchy in the beginning, so it would not surprise me if there's a bit, you know, a bit of a, like, a bit of a dip. No worries, I won't turn it out into an all-out brawl. I would hope not. Nothing like making it super awkward on stream.
Now that you're here watching the stream as the moderator, I'm going to interrogate you.
It's staple for me now. Yeah, the bitrate. I don't know why. When I first launched the stream, it was like, it was bad.
My network sucks.
For a second there, I could only hear every other word you were saying. Well, I know something that happens a lot too is I talk a little spacious. Sometimes I take like I say a couple words and then there's a pause and then I say a couple more words, and so it's probably not you know, it couldn't. It could have been choppy, but it also could have just been me sounding choppy. Don't worry. Eventually, my stream of thought will come in, and I'll just start saying psychobabble. Then you'll all be regretting it. Then you'll wish I hadn't said anything. I forget, did I ask how everyone is? How is everyone? I'll say it again. I'm just gonna keep repeating myself.
Guys, why aren't you replying to me?
I'm just... if she does join, I'll just ask again. If no, that's fine. Yeah. Pretty much. Nothing like, you know, just a simple... question. Nobody wants it to feel like obligation. Though then again, it from again outsider looking in, it sounded like she was already like, this is this most freaking bullcrap. Sounded like she was very upset with it. Though I think that was on Sunday where she was just like, this freaking sucks. I have no idea. I've only seen what she's typed in Twitch chat. So who knows? Maybe she's just like, I hate music festival. She went from being a legend at it to retiring. She hung up the guitar. Or whatever the heck the instrument is. A bass guitar, a drum. The triangle. Why don't they just DM each other? True.
Polly's playing babysitter.
Nah, I would like it. I would like to think, it definitely doesn't require me to be babysitter. But that's always the weird thing about getting people to play games, you know?
Dude, I'm ready to play. Yeah, I'm ready to get online.
And then it's like, ah, they're busy, and then vice versa. If it became that bad, where like I get like private messaged, it's like, dude. They're not responding to me. I'd be like, you gotta stop that. I barely even, I don't even think I've private messaged Ghost Kitten, and she's my moderator. But hey, so far, under her rule, nothing has happened. Now, to be fair, nothing happened beforehand either, but under her rule... My god, 15 stream streak. So I think Lion Teamers is probably all the way up to like, what? He's probably up to like 20 now, right? If I had to guess. But hey, that's the way that I like it. The less that I have to get involved with moderation or random chats.
This person sent me a message and I didn't like it.
And it's like, oh. The moment I start receiving those messages,
that's when I'm gonna get freaking PO'd. I'm gonna get so heckin' mad.
That's when it really will start to feel like I have to be a dad or something. It's like, now, children. Stop complaining repeatedly. But until that day, I am gonna let it sort itself out. Until something heinous happens. Listen here, am I gonna have to sit you kids in the corner? I will turn this car around. We're not in a car. I will get us in a car and turn this around. Isn't that the moment that like every parent is like secretly like, you know, that they can't wait to do, where they're just like, man, I'm gonna pull that out. Like, I wonder if that's how it started, right? It's like, well, my dad said it when we were kids, so I can't wait to say it when I have kids. I will turn this car around. That is a huge bluff, though, on a parent's part. Like, I will turn this car around. Like, you're already halfway there, and you're just like, I don't want to turn around. Like, this is... I just want to get this over with. But you have to stand your ground. You have to fend it off with a stick. But yeah, luckily so far, I have not had to be the mean old parent
yet. Just so happens I haven't had to do it yet.
My ex always said, I'll turn this car around, and never did. Her kids began to laugh at her because they knew she was bullshitting.
I mean, yeah, like, it's a huge bluff on your part.
Because, like, 9 times out of 10, you're either taking them someplace that you have to go. And so you're just like, well, I can't turn around. Or you're taking them to someplace that you know that if you turn around, you're just going to listen to it worse. You know, freaking Disney World or Disneyland, or if it is like a huge trip, you're like, oh, well, let's go to Kings Island or Cedar Point. And then it's like, you're like 30 minutes into the drive and it's like, I will turn this car around. And you're just like, I really don't want to turn the car around. We're already... Have you ever banned anyone that isn't a bot? I don't think so. If I have, it was a really long time ago. Luckily, very many people have been at least semi-respectful. Or so obviously douchey that it comes off as comedic. Like the guy that tried to get me to say Ligma. And it's like, you know, it's like, huh. Like, what do you think I am, stupid? I don't think so, but we've come close. Hey, there's always a first for everything, you know? Again, I generally don't want to take the road of like, this dude said something bad, immediate ban. If I was to immediately ban somebody, it would be probably like a huge bit. It'd be like a 24-hour thing, and I'd be like, okay, he'll come back tomorrow. Turn this car around. But yeah, I don't want to ban people. But I will shake my fist at you really hard. I feel like timing out people will be the first thing that I do a lot of. Because again, like, unless you're just like blatantly like, screw you, like, you're just like, series of obscenities and curses. Because yeah, people can say that I'm bad at a game or something. You know, people can clown on me all they want. But the moment it starts getting a little too deep, I can just delete you. The power will go to my head immediately. Paul and I are gonna pretend to get into an argument to cause drama for the stream, then you can unban me. It just turns. Yeah, we try to create our own controversy, you know. Maybe some YouTuber will cover it. Small time streamer gets into huge conflict with fans. That has to have been done. You know, some guy who's trying to like artificially become relevant via controversy. Or I guess, you know, what's his name? Boogie or whatever the heck. He's just doing it legitimately though. But like clearly that's the only way that he's staying relevant. There's no such thing as bad publicity. Unless you're in a court of law. And then, you know, then it changes. You gotta talk about how people's anime waifus suck. I don't think anybody here watches a ton of anime. Which is ironic, because I think Lion Teamer's Steam profile is anime. There's my diss. There's my light diss. There's my talk of anime waifus. Who here has strong opinions that I can slightly poke at for controversy? I thought it was a furry. Nah, I think that's his Twitch. Nah, his Steam profile, pretty sure is an anime picture. Which again, I don't care. But hey, that was the closest thing I had to anybody who had strong opinions to anime waifus. See, now that I said that I would poke at them. Nobody's gonna admit to it though. They're like, oh, you know, you know, I'm really into, I don't know, what's a freaking character that I can, freaking somebody. I can't even think of one. Well, actually, I don't have Lion Teamers on Steam, so I don't know. Hey, you know, that could always be fixed. That could always change. But yeah, until I hear of someone's strong opinions about anime, which nobody here has given me that sensation, I might have the strongest opinions here, which is kind of sad. And it's not even about waifus, it's just like some anime. So Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney, win. Well, let's see. Phoenix Wright. I don't think I own it. So first I would have to own it. So that's the first major step. I think Bleach is overrated. I'll start the anger train. Yeah, I could agree with that. I think much like any anime that has gone on for like 200 seasons, you can watch like five. You can watch five seasons and get the gist of it. And then you're like, and then you can kind of just nitpick around it. Because, I mean, you get the gist of it, you know, like, I think there's very few anime that you can watch and be like, okay, like this is pretty solid. But like even Dragon Ball Z, like, you know, this is my strong opinion. It's a good anime. But you gotta admit, some of them went a little long. I don't like waifus. I just don't mind a little anime. Oh, well, yeah, there you go. So that's why. Okay. So, which again, like we were saying, I don't think anybody here has any strong opinions about anime waifus that I can start controversy with. But I think we had this conversation before where, like, things like One Piece, where it's like, there's 7 billion episodes. It's like, you don't need to watch all 7 billion episodes. You watch, like, the first couple seasons, and then you watch maybe, like, an arc. You know, you watch, like, a couple episodes in between, and you're like, okay, that's it. That's all I need to watch. You don't need to watch the whole thing. Yeah, see, that photo right there, you would think, like, that guy's into anime waifus. but yeah, I remember you saying that you were like, you know, I'm not even really that into it. But at first glance, Dragon Ball Z is better watched in clips on YouTube. When you sit down and watch the whole show, you realize how much talking there is and how unnecessary it is. I mean, yeah, like, they're like, Dragon Ball Z is a good anime, but like, even it has the thing of like, it just goes on for a little too long, unnecessarily long. You know, by all means, it can go down in the halls of history as being one of the greats, but there's a big but there. Even it can overstay its welcome. But I feel like that's just every show in general. Like, you go on, if you're going on for 100 seasons, like, you're gonna run out of steam. You can't keep going like that. Which is why I enjoy things like Cowboy Bebop. You know, it's a solid anime, and it didn't overstay its welcome. Has a good story, good soundtrack, good animation, solid. First anime I liked was Voltron for like 15 years. I don't think I ever watched a ton of like... I don't know, I never got into like mechs, you know? Which is basically what Voltron is. I mean, it's just a giant mech. Never got into like big mech animes that I'm aware of. I'm sure there's probably one that I'd be like, oh, that one? Yeah, that one's solid, but... I definitely don't think it would be bad. I mean, Voltron's a classic. I mean... a little more to it than mechs. Well, I mean, yeah. I mean, again, it's that, like... I don't know. There was one series... that I bumped into, and yeah, like... It definitely burnt me out on just, like, big robot fights. But yeah, obviously, you know, again, out of all of them, Voltron's a classic. You know, you can appreciate that. Again, it's like Dragon Ball. You can look at the classics and be like, okay, that one's okay. But the biggest one that I've heard, like, controversy of was, Jujutsu Kaisen, where apparently that one's just like bombing horrifically for the mangas or whatever. So even though it's getting its own, you know, anime, it's I don't have high hopes for it. But you see the problem here, I'm not creating enough controversy, I'm not saying strong enough opinions. Like, I can't make fun of the classics, because how do you make fun of the classics? They're classics. I think I liked it because Roblox did an event about it, and it was the day I had to make a new Roblox account. Grind through the event again. I think I had like 2 days to finish it. You just got indoctrinated by Voltron. You got brainwashed by Voltron. I could see that though. I mean, yeah, where you're just like, eh. Like, you just kind of look at it and you're like, eh, it's kind of cool. And then, yeah, you just keep doing it and you're just like, okay, this is pretty neat. Like... I could definitely see that. So I don't think I ever had, well, that I know of. I don't think I've ever had like an experience like that where it's, eh. I mean, I guess the classics, like the classic thing would definitely be the fact that I've seen other people watch something, and then that's when I got hooked on a show. But that's, you know, that's like a common. It's a common situation. It was my first grinding thing as well. It was the first time I had to really just do a repetitive task. That's always a very interesting thing too. And like your first time playing a game that it requires you to treat it like a freaking day job. You're like, nah, it's fun because it's video games. And then like 5 years later, you're like, what am I doing? Like, like, how did I get into this mess? it's like every MMO player's entire career. It wasn't repetitive. If it's grinding, it's repetitive. Like, now, it was enjoyable, so it didn't feel repetitive. You had to do different challenges. Yeah, but the act was still technically repetition. It was just well made. It sounds like it was done way better than most, like, nowadays, like, grinding. Do this thing 300,000 times. Whereas there, it's like, oh, you have to do this thing once, the next day, do another thing, different, you know. But it was still technically grinding, which is an act of repetition. And different games to unlock new stuff. Yeah, it just sounds like they did a very good job about it. Which you can appreciate for, like, more classic... I'm sure that's how people felt with, like, World of Warcraft when it first came out. No, I swear. I swear it was different back then. But I suppose we should transition. I have court to do, you know? I have a job to do. I think. Though I'm sure I'm going to be immediately fired from it. At a rapid pace. No. Know that I'm gonna get fired?
There are things worse than ever in the Banana Republic, a somber island country. While anarchists roamed the street, corruption was running.
Keep talking. That's the whole thing I do, is talk. I'm talking right now. Is this the options? I don't know. I want to turn down this music. Everything else I think should be fine. Yeah. This is fine. Turns out this game is very simplistic. Do like Lethal Company. How does... What does that have to do with... I say that I do Lethal Company and then I just never do it. I mean, to be fair... I mean, in Lethal Company, you are, like, by yourself repeatedly, so you are just kind of talking to yourself.
But we have court meetings to do, money to take, cigarettes to smoke.
That's a good message to start off with. Oh, yes or no. The entire stream is just... questions that are yes or no. Nah, I'll answer in-depth questions. Lily Brown, hello, hello. How are you doing? I'm doing pretty good. How about you? We're just about to start. Judge Sim. Also, I think I asked everyone three times now if how they're doing, and I don't think anybody answered but me. And now Lily Brown. But it's good to hear that you're doing well. Yeah.
Good things are good. Okay, we should really get this Judge Simon going.
How's your stream going? It's going pretty well.
Everything's good. Everyone's positive. I'm willing to accept any and all bribes from the people that I'm going to court with. All good things here.
Oh, there's not a single lick of dialogue.
Your name.
Oh.
Plungus.
Or no, it'd be... Oh, yeah, it'd be Plungus. It'd be... Plungus.
a good solid judge name. Judge Plungus. You're a daily streamer? Pretty much, Monday through Friday. Sometimes we do some Sunday stuff. Take my money. That's clearly what's happening here. It has your name written on it right there. Lion Teamers. You're handing me this wad of cash that isn't dirty in any way. You have a mail. Yes, I have one mail. Dear Plungus, you were appointed as a judge. I knew it'd pay off that single day of law school. Which game do you play most? So far, I don't think any single game has gotten a ton of attention. I do a lot of variety streaming. I like to dabble around. A genre we do the most, though, is probably horror. Apparently, I have a letter to read before I go to court. Your Honor, first of all, as the Ministry, we wish you success in your new position. We wanted to remind you of the details that are important for you to make a correct judgment. You can find the evidence in the evidence file. At the same time, you get information whether there is digital evidence on the tablet. The case file includes the content of the case and the information of the defendants. You can ask some questions to the defendants by clicking on microphone. These questions will play an important role in deciding your case. On the tablet, you can access some digital evidence, such as camera footage or audio recordings. You can also access the recordings of your dialogue with the defendants via microphone. These recordings will be added at the end of your dialogue with the defendants. What's your goal on Twitch? Right now, I suppose just, you know, getting more people. You know, it's always good to see more people, more faces. Just some junk money, tell the cops and you'll go ahead. Hey, you know, I'll take what I can get. Look, if the bribe is like $20, you know, cost of living is rising, you know. The law book contains the rules and penalties for crimes that you need to look at to make the right decision. Finally, you will make your decision. Remember, your decisions will have consequences. Making wrong decisions in law book cases will cause your bars to increase. How full your bars are affect the probability of getting a 12 on the dice screen after each case. Therefore, remember that the game can end even if your bars are not completely full. Well, I don't know what the heck that was. A deal's a deal. And what if I just made the decision now? I'm just like, yeah, we're good. Okay. Possibility of arrest. Possibility of being assassinated. Whoa. I feel... I saw your stream channel. You need to change something in your stream. Whatever would that be? I hope you can pass a guilty verdict immediately to everyone in this game as soon as they walk into the courtroom. Guilty! As a friendly, I'm saying that I can suggest you something. Ah, you're suggesting something. Okay. Hey, suggestions are free. Let's see here. The criminal must be given the sum of their sentence for the crimes listed in charges section. Crimes and punishments. Homicide crimes. So far, I don't even know what this guy is here for. Let me see. I just tap the microphone really loudly. Boom, boom, boom. Let's see the case file. Oh. What is the case file? Is this the case file? This case does not contain any evidence file. Is this the case file? Okay. You have a Discord? Yes, we do. It is down below in all the panels. There's also a shortcut that you can type in chat. Back, you did it backwards. exclamation point Discord. Is what you gotta do. Case file, name, James, surname, Adley, age, 26, gender, male, fingerprint, whatever the heck that is. 212341. It's exclamation point Discord, not Discord exclamation. Yeah, there you go. The Banana Republic Court. Charges. Violation of restrictions. Details. James Adley, who has sent by the patrolling police at 0200. Or 2 o'clock. I don't know. Are we doing military time? Or is... We're just trying to be fancy with it. After the specified restrictions time of 2200 was taken into custody on the grounds that he did not allow the criminal procedure to be applied. I've sent a request. Please accept it. That probably won't happen immediately, but I'll be sure to check out your message. Sadly, there is no tacos command. Okay, so, taken on the custody of grounds that he did not allow the criminal procedure to be applied. So he's just resisting, yeah, he's resisting arrest. Here in the Banana Republic, it was around, 0150, whatever the heck you want to call it. And I wasn't feeling well. At that moment, I forgot that there were restrictions and I was just wandering around. I saw the police while they were on patrol and remembered that there were restrictions, then I insisted on not being punished. It sounds like he admitted it. It sounds like he admitted his crime. Yeah.
Guilty. This man admitted doing crime. There's no evidence. How do I give him the fullest thing of the law?
What do they call it? Violations of restrictions? Is that a thing I can charge you with?
Verbal assault. I don't know what I'm charging you with, but you clearly did something.
Crimes of instigation. Verbal theft, homicide. Aiding and abetting, kidnapping, willful damage, failure to fulfill.
I suggest the death penalty, Your Honor. This is the freaking Banana Republic after all. You deserve the highest punishment of the law.
Money laundering, bid rigging, match fix, drug trafficking. Taking part in organized criminal activity, high treason, terrorism, cyber crimes, violations of traffic safeties and rules. I don't think we have a thing for him. Am I mistaken? How can I help you? Offer a bribe. Why am I offering a bribe? You should be offering me a bribe. There's no speaking records, no emails. I can apparently just start shopping.
Hey, God, the court's adjourned. I gotta buy a new cat tree for mittens.
No digital. I mean, yeah, it sounds like this is a very straightforward case. Why didn't you allow the police to write a fine?
Because I thought I was right, and they didn't give me a chance to explain. I didn't want it to come to this.
please accept my request. I'm waiting for you. You've sent me a message. I will read your message after. If that's a problem, then I'm sorry. But oh well. In your statement, you said you didn't feel well during the night. Why didn't you call an ambulance? As I said, Your Honor, the first thing that came to my mind at the moment was to go out, and while I was doing it, I didn't think of the details. That's not really a defense. Your defense can't just be oopsie doodles, I did that.
Well, seems that you are getting sent to death. James Adley, you are guilty.
I have no idea what the thing is. I'm assuming it would be a fine of, I don't know, frickin' $1,000. That sounds right. Hang on, can I, like, double check this? Because clearly the whole point is that I have to do this right. $7,500 for violations of traffic safety and rules. There's traffic. But there's nothing about, like, I don't know, like jaywalking. It's my Discord, all right. Yeah, I know. I'll accept it after. But yeah. It's good to know directly. But yeah, there's nothing here about for damage to property, public property, failure to fulfill commitment. There's nothing here about like violation of restrictions, public prosecution offense. This is like the closest one. I guess. Nothing else comes close. Physical assault crimes. Public prosecution offense. I guess that it would be this. So they're saying 6 months public service and $1,000. Sure. Let's see if I can do both. So he's guilty. $1,000. And 6 months. Public service. I think that's right. He will get assassinated. I guess. I have no idea. Something's up with my family.
Something's going on with my family.
Also, as a judge, I'm dead broke. Okay, we can poke the cat.
Well, they're all just staring at me, really creepy-like.
My mental health is great. I guess I'm going outside. Let's go to a bar. Let's immediately become alcoholic.
I don't have any money. I'm a judge and I'm broke.
I guess I'm ending the day. That's the creepiest part. Yeah, I wasn't expecting family life in the game. Yeah, like that's the creepiest part about this game. Not the fact that I'm judging people or you know, anything like that. It's my family all waiting for me on the couch staring at me. Daily news. Bill passed. Convicts with a criminal record will now be given increased penalties.
You love to see it. You absolutely love to see it.
I'm definitely getting a Papers, Please vibe, though. The fact that I can get assassinated. I have to deal with mental health, my family. I don't get why I have to make a bribe, though. Let's see the case file. Oh, yeah, I forget. They want me to see the case file first. Name, Axel. Surname, Brendan. Age, 27. Gender, male. Criminal record, yes.
This is your second time here, sir.
Well, potentially more. Show up to the courtroom drunk tomorrow. I would, but I have no money. Apparently, as a judge, I'm doing this as community service. to the Banana Republic Court, charges possession, carrying drugs. A small amount of drugs were found on the person named Axel Brendan, who was subjugated to an identity check by police in the evening as a result of his body search. As a result of the identity scan, it was seen that the person had already had been tried and acquitted twice before on charges of possession carrying drugs. As a result of the subsequent investigations, no evidence was found that the person named Axel Brandon was involved in drug dealing.
Jail.
Jail one day.
This is just going to be a minor inconvenience for you.
His statement. I admit that I carry the substance, but I only use it in my own environment and when I and when I'm alone. Which, again, that's... If you're found with it, that's still a crime. to calm my mind. I have not harmed anyone and never will. I will not use this substance from now on. Well, at least we have his word. Possession of carrying drugs. Okay, now let's question him. Were you going to sell this stuff before you caught... before you got caught in the ID check? No, Your Honor. I was just on my way home and suddenly I saw the police checking IDs. I wanted to change direction, but I was already on their radar.
Where did you get the stuff from?
I get it through a friend. I don't know from whom he gets it.
Is the person you call my friend your close friend?
No, Your Honor. He's someone I met at a bar called Grand Pub a month ago. I don't know him personally.
Release him. I can't release this man. He's admitted to it.
Yo, are there any freaking... Oh, there is actually audio. Oh, this is the audio from what we talked about.
Hang on, I have to do some more shopping.
There's no digital evidence. They're taking it easy on me. So this guy... Freaking... He's got 5 milligrams of cocaine. It helps you calm down? Cocaine?
Financial crimes, narcotic crimes, possession, 10 months public service, aggravated sentence, 18 months, 4 grams is illegal. I mean, yeah, for freaking cocaine, I think 1 gram. it's crazy though, 10 months public service.
What kind of world we live in?
Oh, no, there it was. And $5,000 fine.
Yeah, you're guilty, my guy. I keep forgetting I have to click on him. It's $5,000, they said? I could just raise it. $5,000 and 10 months community service. Or public service. Apparently you get no jail time. I think I did that right.
Look, I am nothing if not a law-abiding citizen.
Now, please, for the love of God, give me a bribe. I'm running on nothing. I don't want no coke addicts cleaning up my highways. Yeah, like, it seems kind of weird that they're like, it's just community service. It's like he was carrying around cocaine. Or the thing that I appreciate is it's to calm my mind. It's like, I think you're taking the wrong thing there, buddy. This guy's here for wanted murder. Apparently, I did do something wrong, though, because I'm up at 10% for getting possibly arrested.
What? Like, I didn't do anything wrong. Actually, I probably did. I keep forgetting to look at the case file.
Jason Amstrad, 42. He has no criminal record. Let's see. Charges, assassination. I was right. You know, he was a wanted killer. We're about to have our lights shut off. Broke-ass judge. I mean, yeah, like, I thought judges were supposed to get paid really well, and here I am.
I'm making a few bucks.
During the night, Freddie Kulse, CEO of Glenswick,
was found dead in the trunk of his car during a routine patrol by the car park security. It had been determined that the CCTV camera covering the area where the incident took place was not working at the time of the incident. Security guard Jason Hamstred, who was the only employee in the company at the time of the incident, became a suspect and was taken into custody by the police. His statement, Jason Hamstred says, "On the evening of the incident, only 3 hours had passed since I started work. While I was doing my routine hourly patrol, I saw Mr. Coles' vehicle, but the open trunk of the vehicle caught my attention. When I approached the vehicle, I saw Mr. Coles' lifeless body in the trunk. What caught my attention about the body was that it had a red rose on it. Afterwards, I immediately notified the police." This guy sounds innocent. He turned himself in. There's no evidence. He looks like he wants to kill me. But technically,
how do you think the killer entered the car park undetected without an ID?
I can't find any answer to that, Your Honor. The doors have never been used in the system since I started my shift.
Did you find a problem with the CEO of the company, Freddy Kosh? Did you know him well?
Glenswick is a really big company, my guy, my dude. I know them by name. I started 3 months ago. I only interviewed with the recruitment department, and I had no problems with him.
And then I just throw the gavel at him. If he catches it, he's an assassin. You know, clearly. This one's a little harder. Because there's just... I'm sorry, what is this? This... What? What the heck do I have? What the heck was that? I thought it was a bomb. Apparently I did something. I did a boo-boo. So, we're at a bit of a weird spot. So I can't try again with whatever the heck that was. Did I like black something out? Why do I have a funny suitcase? Patrolling the routine, blah, 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 it was not. There's nothing here that mentions a suitcase, especially one that had like a weird device attached to it. So I'm kind of up. I got nothing. Big Nemol. I hope I said that right. Thank you for the follow. It's very much appreciated. I got nothing. I got no evidence, but this guy going, I didn't do it. He's the only guy that didn't, oh, whoops. I think I was supposed to, read this fancy, letter. Your Honor, a lot of evidence is lost as a result of anarchist attacks on our state. In order to ensure the security of the evidence in the cases, we will deliver the evidence to you in a device we call Cryptex. We designed the passwords on this device so that only you can solve them and remember. If you try to open it 3 times before the green light turns on, the Cryptex will destroy the evidence. I didn't know that! They should have made that a little clearer. I'm pretty sure. We
Okay, so they gave me a weird, funny box for evidence. They wouldn't have done that if the guy was innocent.
Oh yeah, Big Nemole. Well, your streaming quality is fantastic and your gameplay is impressive. I'm surprised you don't have any more viewers.
Sorry, Big Nemole, but your thing does come off as a bit spammy. I'm gonna time you out. Actually, I think your message was just deleted. If you're not a bot, well, sorry, you've been timed out for a little while. And if you are a bot, oh well. a lot of evidence is lost as a result of anarchist attacks on our state. In order to ensure the security of the evidence and the cases, we will deliver the evidence to you in a device we call Cryptek. Okay, so I done screwed up the frickin' thing. You know, I've screwed up the old doodad. So, I'm gonna assume this guy assassinated a dude. And I'm gonna send him to jail for 62 years. Because I done screwed the pooch.
Oh, when you time out, I think it deletes the message too. Ah, well, that's fair.
A good solid 62 years. This is what happens. This is what happens in the court. This is what happens when I have to ban somebody. I ban them for 62 years.
I was going to time them out myself, but I don't care how you feel about the strictness of these promoters.
Well, I try to treat everyone like they're human, but admittedly, when your message comes off as extremely spammy or bot-esque, it does kind of turn into a bit of like a sticky wicket. Which again, if they aren't a bot, you're just being timed out. You'll have a chance again to not sound like a bot. But I have a feeling they're a bot. I hate robots. Why can't things just be on paper? I hope that guy did crime. But I don't think he did. I'm pretty sure I sent a man away who didn't do crime. Am I actually getting a paycheck? My salary is $600. What? And my house rent is $300. Shopping is $120. What is this? Like the 30s? Like what kind of money am I getting here? And why? shopping is $120. Okay, so we have we have $100 to play with. It's my balance. Withdraw money. Freaking give me my money. Withdraw money. Withdraw it all. I don't know if I should be concerned about this. I'm not gonna worry about credit.
Hang on, guys. I gotta work on my finances.
Welcome to the world of AI. True. Also, it was very funny because Big Nemole's account is already suspended or deactivated due to suspicious activity. So I'm pretty sure he was a bot. Looking over at the post. My daughter has something to say. Your daughter asks you for $100 for her school fees. Do you accept? Your sanity will drop if you don't accept it. My sanity's gonna drop if I do accept this. $100 in school fees. Why do I I'm a judge. I should be the most corrupt person here. Your daughter asks you for $100.
I guess there goes my money. Well, it was nice knowing you, family.
Don't give me that smile, you friggin'.
AI synth Cybermen are not allowed in this stream.
Hey, if a Cyberman wants to be allowed in this stream, they gotta play ball. But the fact that you come in here and not 6 minutes later, your account gets suspended due to suspicious activity, you're probably not doing your spamming right. at least your follower account went up unless they get removed when their account. Yeah, well, that's the reason why I checked it. I saw it didn't move and it was just super funny because it's like it's not the first time that something like that's happened where it's like they leave a follow and then like immediately get deleted. But it was something that I thought was amusing and I felt like checking. Bob Isaac Groove. Age 34, gender, male. He has a criminal record. And Connell Glean, 32, has no criminal record. To the Banana Republic Court, charges for auto theft. Details, the vehicle was stolen while parked in a parking lot opposite the neighborhood where Lemon Diaz lives. Who the heck is Lemon Diaz? Also, that achievement was very late. I got an achievement for giving my daughter $100. The vehicle was stolen following a denunciation on the morning of the night. The vehicle was thought to have been stolen. The license plate was traced. The vehicle was turned over the same morning, and as a result of the searches, a package containing cigar scissors was found in the vehicle. Apart from this, no additional findings were found. As a result of the identity check, the person inside the vehicle was determined to be Bob Isaac Groove, nicknamed Big, known as a former car thief. Lemon Diaz says, "We went to our summer house in Counting Village with my car for 2 days as a family over the weekend. At the end of the second day, I thought I forgot to lock my car because I was tired from the road. There's a possibility that the person who stole it also took advantage of this." And then it was gone. Maybe these Twitch bots are early Institute Sith models trying to get the Gen 3. They got a long way to go. statements from Bob Isaac Groove, or Big. On the morning of the day, the car was thought to have been stolen. A longtime friend of mine, Connell Glean, called me and said he had urgent business. He asked me to take his package to a place called Party Time. I thought it was urgent, so I went quickly to Connell Glean's house. Connell gave me a car key and a piece of paper with the address of the place where I was to take the package. So I stole a man's car to do it. So I drove off with the car. Soon I got pulled over and found out the car was stolen. Upon this statement, Connell Glean was found in his home and brought to the police station for questioning. Connell Glean's statement: "I do not accept any of the accusations against me. I don't know anything." I mean, I'm pretty sure even if it's a big whoopsie, it's still a crime. So Bob Isaac Groove would probably still be arrested. But the big question would be Connell Glean, who I would say it sounds like he has a correlation. Okay, so hang on, but I have to, what the heck? Why is the evidence gotta be so weird to get into? Evidence, cigar scissors and box found in the vehicle. 212-314. 212-314. So it was his I mean, yeah, it's exactly like what I said. He's also guilty. 212314. Right? It was 314? Yeah, 314. There is digital evidence on the tablet.
There's digital evidence. That looks like a guy.
Thordo Dizzy, thank you for the follow. It's very much appreciated. Hope you enjoy the stream. CCTV footage of the scene of the incident. This is nothing. This image right here is nothing. Yes, Bob is a synth. Next trial. Continue the next trial. This image here is nothing to me. Like, there's no facial recognition. I could assume. I guess maybe that's what it's about. Like,
does it look like one of the people?
It looks more like him than it does him. He's like way skinnier, right? Yeah, he looks way skinny. But there's already evidence saying that he was in the car. Like, he was caught with it. But he did something to the car. So they're both guilty. I don't even have to talk to them. I can just say that they're both guilty. But I guess I'll do out of obligation.
Where were you the night that the car was stolen?
That night I was sitting at a place called Peppies with my girlfriend before it was too late at night. I dropped her off at her house and went to my home. I fell asleep shortly after in the morning. I woke up to Connell's call.
When was your last conversation with Connell Glean?
It had been almost 6 months since we last spoke to Connell, and I was very surprised that he called after all this time. I thought the flags were hats they were wearing. Yeah, it is very amusing on how they're perfectly lined up. Guys, can we move the flags? It's bothering me. It's really making this hard to take them seriously. Also, it's been a long time since I left those jobs. I'm now in a regular life, a regular relationship. I'm not guilty. Weren't you caught in the car? When did you meet with Bob Isaac Groove?
I have known Bob for over 20 years. He is a dear friend.
Mr. Groove says you gave him a stolen vehicle delivering
delivered a package and asked him to take it wherever he wanted. Is this true?
It has nothing to do with me. The last time I met Bob, it was 6 months ago. Bob has slandered me.
Wait, I need to reread this. Am I already drinking on the job? I thought it said that he was caught, like, red-handed. In the car. Fortnite live event on Friday. You gonna stream it? Or do you have it? Or do you hate it that much?
Do you just hate Fortnite?
You know, that's a good question. Will I ever stream Fortnite? I don't like to say no to anything just because, you know, like, I might, you know, there might come a time where I will. But I have never played Fortnite ever, and it feels like that would be a very weird thing for me to stream. I mean, I thought he was, his hand was, wait, what? I doubt his hand was red. Is what you're trying to spell, maybe? I have no idea. I thought his hand was red. He asked me to take just the live event just for a little fun. Hey, it's always possible. You never know. I could get cornered in the Fortnite market. There was a Voices of the Void event. That I did see. It's been a while since I've streamed that too. Fortnite, Voices of the Void. Not a event update Oh, update. My brain got scrambled. True. Well, yeah, I kind of got what you meant.
It's been so long since I played Voices of the Void.
Which is, it's such a good game. The fact that it's free on itch.io, you know, like, it's insane. Let's see. Donald Glean called me and said he had urgent business. He asked me to take his package to the place called Party Time. I thought it was urgent, so I went quickly to Connell's house. Connell gave me a car key and a piece of paper with the address. Okay, so here's the thing. He didn't know it was what he was doing was illegal, but I feel like that's not a defense. You can't just be like, oopsie doodles, I got tricked into driving a stolen car. Like you still drove a stolen car. And now Castlevania chapter for DBD. Yeah, and I was informed that Five Nights at Freddy's is legit coming to Dead by Daylight. There's a lot happening, you know, a Friday could be anything. So, honestly, I would say that both of them... Yeah, that doesn't hold up in court. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Like, he got tricked, which sucks, but, like, he still drove a car that was stolen. The criminals must be given the sum of their sentence for the crimes listed in the charges section. Criminals with a criminal record should be given aggravated punishment. Oh, whoops. I think that's... I probably messed that up before. So this would have been... blah, 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 blah. It's technically... I think they said it was like auto. It was an auto theft. Yeah. Charges was auto theft. So... yeah. 2 years in jail for one guy, 4 years in jail for the other guy with a $2,000 fine. So for him, it's 4 years. Wait, what was the fine? I really wish you could pull this up. Like, $2,000. Jeez. 4 years in jail. With $2,000 fine. And then for you, it's the same, but it is 2 years. Look, I don't want to say that I'm the best judge in the biz. I don't even know if I'm doing... I don't even know if I'm doing it right. FNAF DLC isn't until summer of 2025, though. They announced it super early. Ooh, that's a bad move on their part. That's a lot of hype to build up for something that could possibly fall through pretty hard. Also, this stupid grin that my son's giving me. How good is your driving? Like, in game? I mean, I would like to think it's alright. I would like to think my driving in general is... Dude, do you do donuts in the Walmart parking lot? I feel like if anybody, like, admits, like, okay, I'm just, like, like, I'm always speeding, I'm crashing, like, it's a bold move. Also, I guess it says more about them, because I feel like even if you're a bad driver, you would still be like, yeah, I drive well, like, yeah, I drive all right. Why do I not get paid? Why did my daughter need $100 fees? Statement of emergency declared. Anarchist activists, the government has declared the state of emergencies. won a race in game. What game? What the heck are you on about? Increase Anarchist, the government has declared a state of emergency. Okay, so yeah, we're under a little bit of emergency due to anarchy, but I only do donuts in school zones. During the summer, that's the best. Kong Racing. No, we're doing Mario Kart. We gotta do Mario Kart. What is like the last racing game I've played? Oh, did I disconnect? Oh, I died for 1 second. Yeah, I'm seeing it. Why is my bitrate dying?
Dude, the bots are getting to the Twitch channel.
Garfield Kart. The last racing game I think I played probably was Mario Kart. So Crash Team Racing was a good like off spin of it. And then they made that what was it? Nightmare Kart? It's like Bloodborne. What the heck is going on here? Am I in a custody hearing? What? What? Case subject. The situation of who will take the custody of 12-year-old Ezekiel Robin and his sister, 9-year-old Clara Robin. Defendant, Ben Robin. Plaintiff, Diaz Robin. Trek Superstar Racing. I like the idea of, like, Lion Teamers wanting to play like an actual like serious racing game, and I'm like, okay, Garfield Kart. details. Ben Robin and Diaz Robin recently divorced. A custody case was filed by Diaz Robin and the mother of the children for the custody of their children, Ezekiel Robin and Clara Robin. Stop saying Robin. As a result of divorce, the mother has a certain amount of alimony that she demands from the father.
Out of the way, donkey.
You name it, I'll beat you.
Man, such confidence.
Folly's a Hot Wheels Unleashed kind of guy.
Dude, I only play the most obscure racing games imaginable.
Is that literally the only page? Just which one do I send you off to? Custody case was filed by Diaz Robin, the mother. As a result of divorce, the mother has a certain amount of alimony that she demands from the father.
Are you sad that your parents are divorced?
What kind of question is that? What psychopath of a judge am I? No, I'm not, because my parents didn't get along very well and they argued all the time. My sister and I were very uncomfortable and I couldn't stand the crying of my sister anymore. So do you want to live with your mom or with your dad? What is important to me is my sister. I certainly don't want to leave her, but the best thing for her is to live... the best thing for her would be to live with my mother. Who would you prefer? My mother is more important to me. Oof. I think being with my mother will be better for me and my mother, of course, with my sister. Are you sad that your parents are divorced?
Yes, very, very much. But even though they fight, I love them both very much and I can't live without...
Look, kid, don't phone this in. You gotta play this serious.
You love your mom more or your dad? Again, a psychotic question for the judge. I love them both very much. I never wanted my parents to get divorced. That's why I feel so sad. If you had to choose, who would you choose, your mom or your dad? I don't want to choose one or the other. I only wish right now is that my brother doesn't leave me. He always supports me. Please don't separate my brother and me. Right now, and beating me in a racing game because I'm not in one. There are some incredibly biased questions from the judge. I only play the Mario Kart with Zelda in it. The one with the green hat. Also, I keep blanking out. something about my bitrate is like, I suppose there is a bit of a storm front coming in because the there's a bit of a tropical storm coming down from Florida.
Getting hacked by the Twitch bots.
No, now it's Lion Teamers. He's like, hang on. This is the only way to get him to play a racing game. He's flicking the bitrate on him.
Well, the dad freaking got sent to the curb.
Wet pogas. Pogas? Wet paw gas. Your stream is amazing, so I followed you. That's great. thanks for the follow. If you survive the purge from Twitch, try not to sound like a bot. But I appreciate the follow if you are a legit human being. yeah.
Go away, synth.
again, who knows? Maybe you're a real person, but if you are, don't copy paste your messages to repeated areas. I guess Ben Robin is getting the short end of the stick here. I mean, I don't think there's any. This is literally just like, yeah, this feels like a cold cut case. It's like decision. Give custody of both children to the mother. Give custody of both children to the father. Give the son. Placing children in orphanage due to lack of conditions. yeah. He didn't even, like, nobody defended the dad. He had nothing. He had nothing. Why do they look like they're 80 years old? It's because of the stress. I think I did right. So far, nothing bad has happened to me. I have no money, though. So I feel like I'm still getting the short end of the stick here. This man did some... This guy did a crime. 100%. This guy did a crime. Look at that face. Look at that face and you tell me he didn't do a crime. Okay, this... Why? Why is this like this? So, this one goes here. Yeah. This one goes here. This one goes here. One goes here. This one, man, it's so freaking hard to see because the lines suck. This one goes here. I don't know what evidence that is, but it's probably to put you away. Maybe. Yeah, you have a criminal record. I knew it. Guilty. James Redlow, age 51. Charges assassination. Why is there so much assassination in this town? In the morning, a person named Amanda Sylvia, I don't know how you pronounce that, who was jogging in a forested area near the highway, came across the lifeless body of a person named Francis Crims while jogging. I don't know why we need to preface that they're jogging. It has been determined that the CCTV camera covering the area took place was not working, of course. According to the autopsy report, it was understood that he died as a result of prolonged asphyxiation without any signs of impact on his body. According to the allegations, the last person the deceased was in contact with was James Redlow, a member of the board of directors of Karen and Wells.
James Redlow, that night, we left the company together. We went to the bar called Lose Drop with his vehicle. After staying there for about 1 hour, he dropped me off at my home. I don't know what he did after that or where he went. Francis and I were good friends. While sitting at the bar, I saw him troubled, but no matter how much I insisted, he did not say anything. He just said that there was something wrong in his life these days, and no matter what he did, he couldn't change things. That's all I can say. I'm so sorry for the loss of a close friend. Amanda Sylvia says, that morning, like every day, I headed to the area in the forest that I always prefer to run. You know, where all the dead bodies are. While I was taking a break to drink water, I saw a body laying flat behind the bushes. I immediately informed the police. All I remember is that the person lying on the ground was wearing a suit and had a red rose on him. That's a serial killer. I think I arrested a guy who I thought assassinated, but turns out might not have done it. Rope found near the body and used to kill Francis. The red rose found on the body. Look, man, I'll arrest you too. I've got nothing to lose. And there's no digital evidence. There's, yeah.
How long is your friendship with Francis?
Well, it's a lot shorter now. We've been working at the same company for about 4 years, but we have had a close friendship for the last 2 years. Was there anyone in the company who did not like Francis Crims or had threatened him recently?
No, as far as I know, there's no such person. In fact, he was the CEO of our company, and he was well-liked by every member of the board.
This man's a liar. This man's a killer. Get that guy. Get him. Hit him with sticks.
Did you often go to the bar and question with him?
Yes, we used to go at least twice a week and vent to each other.
Hmm. This man's a liar. You're telling me the man that was killed was a CEO and well-liked? And this, like, you're a liar. You're going to jail. There's no way.
62 years or 102 years? 102 years, yeah. Wait, you have a file, right? It said you did a crime? Yes, okay. 102 years it is.
He ain't getting away this time. Not this time.
Ooh. I'm apparently 50% over the assassination.
As a result of the decisions you made in the cases, we decided to raise your salary this week. You will earn $700.
I thought this was a letter that was gonna say I'm dead meat. I got a achievement that said I was like 50% over gonna get shot.
Wow, I made so much money this week. Freaking get this money.
Yo, $200 in the pot. The moment I get home, somebody's gonna ask for $200. Surprisingly, no.
Okay, bar it is.
Actually, oh, whoops. I meant to go to the casino. I could have gambled. I think I'm getting assassinated because I caught the killer? Maybe? I'm gonna assume it's because I caught the killer and I did a good job. My mental health is great. I have to play this weird funny puzzle game.
What?
What am I even looking at? Hang on. I don't have a note. What? Hang on. It's just a thing of knobs. Eldon Duncan. The owner of Dunkin' Donuts. Age 30. He has a criminal record. That's gotta be why it's called Dunkin' Donuts, right? The guy that made the
place is named Duncan. Charges, threat. Turns out you're a judge in Japan where gambling is illegal, so you go to the casino and immediately get arrested. Now that would be ironic. Though, to be fair, I'm sure that has happened repeatedly. And it's like, why is there a judge on trial for something stupid? Or in the case, highly illegal. Charges, threat, malicious wounding. The incident occurred in the evening of the home of Eldon Duncan, the person named Arthur Darrell, who caused the injury fled immediately after the incident. John Duncan. This man, John Duncan, of the well-known Duncan and Duncan Corporation. An arrest warrant has been issued for Arthur Darrell as a result of the report of the person named Eldon Duncan. Details. And the search initiated by the police was a result of the tip-off. It was determined that Arthur Darrell was hiding in his sister's house and was captured by the police in the evening and brought to the police station for questioning. Eldon Duncan, a month ago, I borrowed some money from Arthur Darrell. He kept calling me and telling me that my debt was doubled and increasing day by day. I told him many times that I had not yet received payment from my workplace and that I would pay my debt when I received it. Despite this, he never stopped calling and harassing me, and after a while, he started following me home. Eldon Duncan continues, although I reported this situation to the police many times, I did not receive a positive response. As I finally left my workplace and arrived at my house, I saw Arthur Darrell behind me and noticed that he was holding a knife, and in his hand, he pointed the knife at me and asked me to be quiet and go to my apartment with him. I couldn't react because I was afraid. Then, we went to my apartment. After entering the house, he started rummaging through my house and looking for money, like a little goblin. When he couldn't find money, he stabbed me in the leg, and then quickly fled the apartment. And then I took my cell phone and asked for help from the police. Arthur Darrell, about a month ago, Eldon Duncan called me and told me that he needed some money. Although I was in a difficult position myself, I gave him the money and asked for that he asked for and explained the situation to him. I then proceeded to stab him in the leg. I mean, he said that he would pay me the money as soon as possible. Since he didn't respond after a month, I couldn't stand it and called him and told him that he had to pay his debt. He told me that he would pay the debt if I came to his house on the date and time he said. When I went to his house, he told me that the money was in his apartment and that he should go and that we should go to the apartment. When we got home, he asked me to sit down and said that he would come back. Then he stood in front of me with a knife and started making threats to me. I told him that he had to pay his debt no matter what. Then he swung the knife towards me. In that moment, I made a move to defend myself and the knife was stuck in Eldon's leg. Afterwards, I took the knife and ran to my sister's house after I was afraid. This could be a trick. So you think we'll see Dinkelberg on trial? There's a very possible chance. I mean, this guy looks like a Dinkelberg. We need that evidence, though, but I have no idea. Oh, it's one of these. Hang on, we'll be here for a while. Oh my god. Why can't it just be in a normal suitcase? You. Whoops. Thank God I can do this as many times as I want. Jesus. Thank God I can do that. Okay, so yeah, because I kind of figured that like this all hinges suggestion to the developers, this stupid minigame needs to go away. This specific minigame. It is a little goofy, because like I feel like the trick should be the actual like crime. Like, it's Judge Sim, not like, hang on, let me go through the rat maze in order to open this box. Telephone conversation dialogue between Eldon Duncan and Arthur Darrell.
When are you going to give me my money back? Give me some more time, please. I return it as soon as possible. I've waited long enough. I can't wait any longer. You don't pay my obligations, ladies. I'm not responsible.
Okay, so it sounds like Arthur Darrell is, in fact, going to stab him. Arthur Darrell, if you don't pay by tomorrow, I'll kill you.
I think Arthur Darrell might be... I think Arthur Darrell might be the criminal here.
21-27-2. So, yeah, basically... Arthur Darrell both made a threat that he would kill... Eldon Duncan. And he has his fingerprints on the knife, which technically would still track for self-defense, because he made it sound like he disarmed, but I would hope that the game would, you know, have that evidence. Yeah, he's a criminal. Right? Yeah, Arthur Darrell. I didn't even talk to them. I mean, I guess I can. How do you know a man... How do you know a man named Arthur Darrell? How do you know the man? Last year, he was someone I met through social media. We met, became friends. In which hand was Arthur Darrell holding the knife when he stabbed you? He was holding the knife in his left hand, and then he stabbed me with his left hand. What? He was holding the knife in his left hand, and when he stabbed me with his left hand, I'm sure of it. How many times a week did Arthur Darrell call you? He was calling and harassing me every day of the week. Did you call and harass Eldon Duncan between the day you lent him money and the day of the incident?
Nope. Nada, I didn't do that. Nope.
I want to see another run of this game on a separate stream where you make the worst sentences possible. I'm sure there'll come a time where I'll do that just now. with which hand did the person named Eldon Duncan point the knife at you?
If I remember correctly, he pointed the knife at me with his right hand.
Why does this... That was like the most needless exchange.
He pointed the knife at me with his foot. He was holding it between his toes. Like...
There's no digital evidence. Arthur. What is the crime for? It's like threats. Technically, he did assault him. Threat and malicious wounding. Verbal assault is 2 years. And then... Malicious wounding is another 8 years, so 10 years.
You're going to jail, buddy. For 10 long years.
And you're good. This is the one person that isn't guilty. They're not guilty. I think. Yeah, near the end of the stream, I'll probably just do something like that, or if I'm in a scenario where I just have to, like, you know, like, my mental health's at zero, everything's going poorly. Let's go to the casino. Yo, okay, here's the thing. We could play some blackjack, or we could do some Wheel of Fortune.
I like the Wheel of Fortune sounding. That one sounds top tier.
Why does the cop look happy and not happy at the same time? He just loves and hates his job. Now, blackjack is a game that I could say is of skill, but this game could be rigged. But at least the Wheel of Fortune is random. And I feel like I can respect that. Hang on, is there like a buy-in? Okay, so we don't have to go... Okay, wait, so... I'll win every time, right? Am I misreading this? If it lands on any of these, I'm making money. Oh, no. Okay, I see it now. I understand. I have to put money on a fruit. Okay. Huh. Okay, this could be rough because I could go all in on the old... Well, no, they all have a 20. The watermelon. Watermelon's the big one. I don't know. I'm starting to kind of feel... iffy about this. I thought it was just going to be like win or lose, but nah. These odds aren't good. I'm so lucky. There's no negative things that have happened. let's see. We have to analyze this. This could be the solid thing. I mean, to be fair, I'm getting a pay raise. This seems like something that it would be better to... Okay, so here's the thing. We will go 50 on watermelon. And I'm thinking... Let's do like 5 on orange or something. 10. Let's do 10. Well, if we go all in on watermelon, that's a big risk. Let's start here. Let's see where this goes.
We could stop it at any time.
You. Watermelon even has a larger slice.
Okay, well now we have to make up for our loss. And so we gotta do this by going more. Now we go all in. Now that we've hit destitution.
Son of a... Well, that's gambling for you. We'll be back. Maybe next time we try blackjack. It's gotta be my paycheck soon anyway, right? Every time I send a message, I freeze the damn stream and I know I don't know what you said. I wonder why you're broke. No reason. I had debts to pay. there's no reason. Bill passed. Criminals who are not mentally well will be sent for treatment instead of punishment. They're only slightly psychotic. Let me guess, this guy's gonna be crazy. Why? Why is this like this? How could you do this to me? He is mental health test positive. Okay, now are they saying he's got good mental health, or are they saying his mental health, like he's positively crazy? he has no criminal record. Howard's roast. Charges willful damage to public property. The incident was discovered by citizens using the benches belonging to the Trenthor municipality. And an investigation was launched following complaints. He was identified on the CCTV footage. As a solution, a new bench was placed in front. And they started
and they started to wait. He sat down on the bench at noon and took a sharp object out of his pocket and was detained by the police officers at the same time.
First of all, I didn't know it was a crime to do this. The reason I did it, though, is I unintentionally picked up a bad habit and it turned into an addiction. I can't control it anymore. But as I said, I didn't know it was a crime to do it.
Okay, well, now I'm more confused than ever. Is he... I think they're trying to say that his mental health is bad. So he failed the test, so he's positive. It's one of those weird things. Like, they could have been more clear, you know. So it sounds like he is unwell. I guess? Well, no, all he did was... I thought he was... Okay, so he just scratched up a bench. And he had a lot of sharp objects on him. Okay, maybe... I thought he was going to do something psychotic with the sharp weapons. He was just vandalizing a bench. So, yeah, I think it's positive, as in he is well. But he has no record. So, yeah. You vandalized. Blah, 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 blah. What? Where the heck is this vandalizing? Where is it? Where is it? Homicide, theft, verbal, crimes of instigation. Yeah, no. Physical assault. Willful damage to public property is 12 months public service. 3,000. 12 months and 3,000. You're going to jail for a long time, but actually you're not. 12 months and 3,000. I think I did that right. I didn't even talk to him, but I didn't have to. I knew deep down in my bones, I knew he was a criminal. Thank God that they didn't want me to do anything. They didn't want my money. These vultures of a family. End the day. I don't even talk to them. I go directly to bed. What is this? What? Case subject, Trinks. A music production company claims that The Wall, a music production company, okay. I got a little confused there. Is using the structure of a track that belongs to them and violating their copyrights. Defendant.
The Wall Music Production Company.
Why is it called The Wall? Plaintiff, Trinks Music Production Company. There is one digital evidence for this case. Trinks Music Company has released a new track in recent weeks. 3 days after the track was released, the music company The Wall released a track of its own. In response, the music company Trinks argued that it's copyright and has been infringed and that it should be paid $10 billion trillion dillion dollars in damages, citing the track's infrastructure as evidence. The lawyer of the Trinks Music Company, we spent a lot of time working on that track, and we were very happy that we finally finished it. But a few days later, we realized that the track released by the music company, The Wall, used the exact same infrastructure that we used. Our problem here is not that they did this, but they did it without permission. We decided to file a lawsuit for compensation, which we hope to get. We request that the appropriate action be taken. The lawyer of The Wall Music Production, the track was created with a completely original infrastructure and the long efforts of our sound engineers. This kind of acquisition is unacceptable. We don't think there's a copyright infringement just because the infrastructure is similar. We're sure that in the tracks was released before them, that they also have tracks that are similar to our infrastructure. We do not want to be victimized by this situation, and we request that the necessary action be taken. That's a bold statement. Yo. These sound totally different, but one's louder. One's like kind of muted.
I mean, I don't know. This is a pretty sticky situation. Like, if I'm going off of the wave, like, they're identical. But I think that might just be the game being like, oh. I'm gonna give someone jail time for this. For wasting my time. Okay, well, that got me nowhere. What do you two have to say for yourselves? Maybe don't make generic music. I mean, yeah, that right now is my biggest thing, is like both of them just sound the same because it's just like we put beats in it. We did some beats. Can I offer you a bribe to get these people out of here? But then, like, their argument is pretty sound as well. Who was it? It was, the wall. The wall basically did the whole thing of, like, we are sure that in the tracks we released before them, they also have tracks that are similar to our infrastructure. So, yeah, it's like, there's a very good chance that that is true. And, they are distinctly different. Both of you buzz off. The wall music production company conviction and payment of $10,000 in compensation was not found not guilty and not to pay any. Yeah, don't pay any compensation. That is bullcrap. They're two different songs. Go away. As a result of the decisions you made in the cases, I get even more money to gamble. Oh my god. I don't know what this dice thing is.
But I just can't wait. Oh my god. Yeah, it's payday.
Woo! Now, I'm definitely getting money taken away from me this time. 100%. I'm gonna go home and my wife's gonna be like, I need seven. Oh, it's you. It's the boy. The boy needs something. Would you look at the time? It's sleep time. Sometimes you do need to sleep. He wants $300 for the new clothes. Do you accept? Your son says his clothes are getting old. He wants $300 for the new clothes. Do you accept? What is this bull crap? No. My clothes are kind of old. You have been sitting still every night when I enter this room. The cat hasn't even budged. I think you guys are all mannequins. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go gamble.
Frickin' $150. Let's see how we doing. 17.
That's not great. I'll probably stay.
Son of a... This game's rigged.
Okay, that's why we didn't go all in.
Because now... We get the big bucks. We get the...
what is... take card. Of course. This game is rigged. This casino is rigged. Well, look, he could have gotten that money. He could have gotten those clothes if he knew how to count cards with me. But no, instead he's sitting there. Just wanting money. Just here I am, apparently getting potentially assassinated every day. What is this case? Joel Mueller sues Sisony for damages for the suicide of his daughter. Defendant Sisony Company, plaintiff Joel Mueller, hospital report. Joel Mueller alleged that his 15-year-old daughter, Ellie J. Mueller, had played the game last Last of Me 2, owned by Sony. Man, the developer of this game is really skirting a line. and that sometime after playing the game, she suffered from depression and subsequently committed the big S. Joel Mueller, who blames Sissoni for his daughter's blah, 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 seeks damages for the amount of $10 quadrillion. Why is it always this much for the pain and suffering that he has suffered? In addition, the plaintiff Joel Mueller requests that the game be removed from sale. Hello, hello, Ghost Kitten. Welcome, welcome. You missed the great purge of mini bots. But luckily Soap was here. Soap might still be here. Riz Burke, one of the company's lawyers, is representing Sissoni in the case. In statements, Joel Mueller, after playing this game, "My daughter shut herself into her room and she never spoke to us. She hardly ate or slept. She was exhibiting behaviors she would never normally do. So we took her to the hospital and she was diagnosed with major depression. MD. After 2 weeks later, her mother came home from work and found her unconscious on her bed, having a box of antidepressants. But we took her to the hospital. It was already too late. Our company never accepts such smear campaigns. Before the release of our game, we stated the legal age limit is 18. Here we see that Mr. Mueller's daughter, Ellie," which again, all the developers skirting a line, "does not meet this age." Understandable after The Last of Us 2. You know, we all have to take things into our own hands. Oof. Here we see that Mr. Mueller's daughter Ellie does not meet the age limit. In this case, the fault lies entirely with the family. You know, that would be a pretty solid defense. Like, we technically said it was 18 old, and yeah, 15 year old daughter. Not only that, but like, this feels so like, I mean, again, this is a very real life thing. But I don't think this ever wins because, like, you don't know what was going through the person's head before. Like, they could have been playing the game to escape their depression, not that the game caused it. And so, like, yeah. As sad of a situation this is, it feels like it's just a, you know, shake fist, you know, cause blame, which would be understandable. Mr. Mueller, your daughter does not meet the legal age limit for the game. Do you think you are at fault in this matter? Your Honor, my daughter borrowed the first game of the series from her friend and played it. When the second game came out, she practically begged me to buy it. As a father, I couldn't break my daughter's heart. The game must be removed so that others don't have to go through what I went through. So your defense is, I would have had to make her sad. That, the yeah. Mr. Burke, what is your defense in this matter? Your Honor, our game has sold a lot of companies around the world, and we've never had an incident like this before. The reason why this happened is because the family acted unconsciously. Moreover, there's no evidence that it was our game that caused the daughter's illness. We think that they are trying to use it to cover up their family problems. I mean, yeah, sadly. That, I mean... ugh. Sadly, they are not guilty. Rejection of, compensation to the family and the removal of the game. No compensation for the family and removal of the game from sale. The rejection of the family's compensation claim and the game remaining on sale. I mean, yeah. There's no other case... this is just a sad thing that happened. I mean, yeah. There is no legal standing here. Now get out of my courtroom. I need money so that I can gamble. Maybe I'm not the best person you should be coming to. Also, I suffered mental damage. So I could theoretically go to the bar when I get money to repair that.
also a very good role model. Members of the Sicilia cartel were caught smuggling drugs across the border. Good for them. Week 4, case 2. They're making more jobs for me. I mean, you know, again.
We're offering you $500 to release Jeremy Alder and Mike Byrne. This money will make your job easier. We will ensure that you are not affected by the decision you make.
Sounds great. I don't know who you guys are. Not guilty. Actually, I could just say you need treatment. Hang on. Are any of you insane? Can I, like, get you off? Nope. Okay, well. I tried my best. Not guilty. I didn't even talk to you. I didn't even open the evidence locker. That $500 is mine. Ooh, moderate possibility. What did I do? You've been arrested. I can't even take a bribe? What is this bull? They said I wouldn't suffer the consequences. Is it because I didn't even, like, make it look legit? Or is it just because of the bad roll? You might be a little corrupt. No. No. There's no evidence of that. Nuh-uh. That's my defense in court. Says who? The criminals? Maybe I have to make it look legit. Yes, I'm doing the... Oh, Jesus, guys, you're making this hard. I know what you are, but what am I? I'm rubber and you're glue. Whatever you say bounces off me and sticks to you.
Look, will you take a bribe?
Maybe that's it. Maybe I should have bribed him. But I have no money. I'm gonna try to do it again. Yes, they didn't do it. These people are innocent. I'm thinking it's because of the dice. So maybe now, okay, yeah. Now I'm safe. Yeah, okay, now I got that $500. That's so stupid. That's such a stupid mechanic. Because, I mean, yeah, like, just make it like Papers, Please. Like, make it so that I suffer a negative and not, I'm gonna gamble my savings away.
I'm going, $200.
I'm not corrupt. I just have my own problem. Okay, we've been through this road before. If I take the card, I'm going to lose. But if I don't take the card, I'm going to lose. what's the rule? I feel like there's a rule, right? 17. 17 is way too high. There's nothing that I can... It's nothing that I can draw, but like a 4. I mean, 4 would be good. Like, are we doing the whole, like, ace is 1 and, what is it, 11? Are we doing that? I'm gonna stay, and they're gonna win. Oh my god! Okay, I retire.
Now we go all in from $700.
I made up for my money that I lost, right? I'm leaving. You'll never see me again, maybe. I'm going to the bar. Screw you.
You hit me with the best stuff you got. I have a big case tomorrow. How much am I missing of my sanity? Frickin' hit me with a whiskey.
$30. This is highway robbery.
Yep.
Why is this red? Oh, it's minus. Well, that's not fun.
You drink one glass of whiskey. If you drink a second, you will go mentally insane.
Okay, son, I could pay for your clothes now, but it seems you've gotten over it. So, I'm gonna go to bed, and we're not gonna talk about this anymore.
Maybe now I need to bribe the officer. Possibility of being assassinated, only 50%. I like those odds. Lower the arrest bar by 25%. $750. Yeah, I'll take my chances. Oh no. Not this again. What fresh hell have I entered? I just wanted to gamble and drink. You know, I might not have been the best person to be a judge. Freaking stupid box. Could you imagine being in a courtroom and you're like, okay, you know, I'm here because of this reason. You know, they caught me and the judge is over here fiddling with the box. Son of a freaking, I gotta fiddle with these switches. Freaking son of a. Ah, god dang. Hang on, I'm almost there. I've almost got the evidence. Just. What was your thing again? Freaking son of a. Freaking. God dang. Jesus. Well, Your Honor. Well, now that I finally got into the funny box for the evidence,
You should play Ace Attorney.
I know Soap was saying I should. He was disappointed that this wasn't that, and I still might. It's a classic game, I know.
Decompte amount 200 from Dennis, whatever that name is, to Sophia Bonza Banana Bank.
She got 200 banana bucks. Receipt for the money sent by Dennis. Telephone call, dialogue between Dennis and Sophia Bonza. Hello, hi. What is your fee? 200 per hour, 500 per night. Which one do you want?
George, is this lady one of them?
I'm starting to think $200 is actually thousands in this universe.
Hello, hello, Mark. Welcome, welcome. I think she's one of them. Yeah, she's one of them.
Hang on, let me see. Oh, fraud. Okay. Woof, woof. Okay, wait. Prostitution. Okay, well, we're back on track. She cleans bathrooms, though, right?
Does she wear one of those funny maid outfits?
Recently, Dennis wanted to have sexual intercourse with.
why is it worded like this?
Whom we thought was oh, so it was just like, whoops, like I thought I got the wrong phone number.
Prostitutes are the backbone of the Banana Republic.
Yeah, so he actually, so she is, in fact, I think, a maid or something, but he thought, who he thought was a prostitute in exchange for money, and the telephone conversations requested a certain amount of money and asked Dennis to deposit it to her account. Did not receive any return after depositing the money. Afterwards, he reported the situation to the police and filed a complaint. Soon after, was arrested and detained at her resident address. I broke up with my girlfriend 2.5 years ago, and during the time, I had no sexual intercourse with anyone. This affected my psychologically.
Look, dude, man, you're caught up without a paddle here. If I'm to read this correctly, first of all, I'm not a prostitute. I've never been. My phone rang recently.
A stranger asked me how much my fee was. At first, I didn't understand, but then I was thinking,
Thinking I was being made fun of, I told him that my hour cost $200. He asked how much he could make the payment. I sent him my bank account, and then I realized that I had $200 in my account. And then I realized it was a serious misunderstanding. I blocked the number. Inexplicably, I realized that my phone number was circulating on the internet on sexually explicit...
What? So everyone here is at fault, but apparently only she's going to get arrested.
Reporting that to the police is crazy.
Man. Okay, so...
Which, again, he would be also arrested. That's how this would work, but apparently only she's here.
What, the other guy get lost in traffic? Like, what?
I remember hearing about cases of people reporting their illegal drugs stolen.
Dude, you have to give me that back.
$200 from Tuesday. Technically she is caught. They're all caught red-handed. Personally, I would say that they both should be arrested, but apparently I'm only getting rid of one. what even is this under? Hang on. What is this? What is that? Fraud? You're being arrested for fraud. That's what we're... You're a fraud.
Her devil magic needs to be locked up. These dang women are tricking men.
I don't think she did anything wrong. I mean, technically, so to my understanding... I am not a judge or a lawyer, but I'm pretty sure it would still be considered fraud. But I'm pretty sure he would also be in some form of trouble because he was trying to hire a prostitute. So the fact that which is funny, there hasn't been very many not guilty people.
My granddaddy told me if it bleeds for 7 days, don't trust it.
But I guess I'll talk to her. Why didn't you tell the person who called your phone that you were not a prostitute? Like I said at the beginning, I thought he was making fun of me. After you realized it was serious, why didn't you send the money back? I tried to send it through the account number of the receipt I was sent, and it didn't work. I would send it somehow later and forgot about it. Tried to send it through the account number on the receipt that I was sent and it didn't work. Okay, that's really the only, like, difficult part is... Like, she says that she's making it sound like she wanted to give the money back and she tried. You know what? Screw this noise. You're not guilty. This freaking case weirds me out. Get out of here. Freaking leave me alone. As a result of the decisions you made in the cases, we decided to raise your salary. Is my salary raising because I'm doing good? Or is it just accidental? Or is it just coincidental? I'll take it, but also, you know, I think I'm gonna get shot. I just got shot.
I didn't know she was a prostitute!
You've been assassinated. I hate the dice rolling mechanic of this game. I think it was when you make the right decision or something. Well, in that case, I've been making a lot of wrong decisions. And I gotta do that case again. Frickin'. It raises every week, no matter what. That's what I was thinking. Like... It was hard to keep track, though, because, like, I can't keep track of time in the case. But hello, hello, Nugget Master 123. A very nice name.
Well, damn.
Yeah, I freaking get rid of the... I say the lady's not guilty, and then I get assassinated because I say she's not guilty. Just put her away now for fraud. Case closed. No, the problem is that it's random. This is completely random to my knowledge. Which is, again, I would say the worst part about this game.
Yes, this sweet, sweet paycheck. Withdraw all of my money. Yes. Yes.
Guess where we're going? To the bar to raise our mental health.
I'd like a nice wine.
$40? Hang on. Freaking get out of my way. I was here last week and it was $40.
What? I might as well just go crazy. I'm not paying for this.
$40 for one glass. Believable.
I mean, it was way cheaper last week.
Assassin was pissed about that prostitute being innocent.
He didn't want that lady to see the light of day.
The inflation. Okay, here's the thing. We'll gamble, and if we can gamble our beer money, then I'll do it. Why does your daughter look so scared? Well, I'm a gambling, alcoholic, bribe-taking judge. You do the math. But the sun's smiling, so clearly something's going on.
Take a card. Woo! That's what I like to see. Screw these guys. I'm going to the bar. Friggin' get me out of here.
I'll take it. I'll take your over. Wait. Okay. I was about to say, like, did the wine go up while I was away at the casino? I'm buying. Wait. Actually, minus 5 mental health. I can't repair my mental health anymore. I'll just damage it more. They're just staring at you while you make bad decisions.
Don't do it. Please don't.
No, it's fine. I've got this under control. I've only been assassinated once.
What? Like, it's just this. The judge is going on a psychotic journey. Actually, I need to bribe the freaking guard, or else, yeah, I'm gonna get assassinated more. I'm really pushing it.
Yeah, I need some special.
$750? Shouldn't you guys be on my side? Like, what? Like, why am I paying you? The Banana Republic. Yeah, that's where we're at, right? The Banana Republic? Where the heck do I... Where do I live? Yeah, the Banana Republic. Like, why am I paying them? Okay, so it only goes up by like 15 if I succeed. So theoretically, I can do all the work now and just play with the dice. I like those odds, you know? There's no digital evidence in this case. Well, I wasn't looking for digital evidence. I was looking for physical evidence. He's not crazy. He has no record. Ahmad El Amin. I don't know if I pronounced that right. Human trafficking. Late at night, while the police were inspecting at the border of the city of Kairos, or whatever the heck that is, a person named Ahmad El Amin did not comply with the stop warning and tried to bypass. Police officers pursued. He fled. There was like a bunch of people in a car. As a result of a long chase, the person was entered a gas station, got out of the vehicle, and tried to escape on foot. Was caught and detained by the police after a while. A large number of foreign nationals were detected in the vehicle. I'm aware that it is dangerous and forbidden for me to do this work, but I was unemployed and penniless for a very long time, so I had to do it. The work and the process was very difficult for me, and I was so nervous. So I saw the police. It doesn't really matter. You did it. You got caught. You human trafficked, and you got caught. Where the heck? Yeah. 8 years. Right? You're not a criminal, right? Yeah.
Now you are.
8 years. Honestly, pretty low for human trafficking. If I fail, I'm getting assassinated. If I fail, I'm getting arrested. My family is still freaky as ever. I would have thrown the book at a human trafficker. Yeah, but I'm apparently already on, like, death's door with assassinations and being arrested. I don't know how. I thought I was doing everything right, but I haven't even done, like, a funny, like, haha, this guy's getting life, and he tipped over a trash can bit, you know? I think I have to gamble. I need to pay off the police for some reason to protect me, even though I'm the judge and I've only took one bribe. Like, that's not that bad. 140. We'll do 140. We only gamble a little bit. I have my limitations. Ooh. Ooh. This seems really... I mean, okay, so what are the odds? What are the odds? Isn't there like an actual rule for blackjack where it's like, oh, if it's like 17 and over or something like that, like you stay, like it's mathematically... I mean, 5... I don't like the odds though, but I feel like I'm screwed either way because he's probably gonna pull out the big guns. I might just stay. I'll stay. Yeah. You always stand on 17. Yeah, I kind of figured. But now what we do is... we double down, sort of. Hit me. Ooh,
that's how you do it. Screw you.
There's a difference between hard and soft 17s. IDK what that means. Yeah, I have no clue. So, but hey. My brain was able to deduce that what I did was the right decision. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a bunch of people to pay off to not get... Uh-oh. In the dark of the night, your sleep is interrupted by the sound of a knocking on your door. Go to the door, unarmed. Look through the hole or wait quietly.
Look through the hole?
See a masked man.
Call the police?
I mean, he was clearly going to kill me.
He was going to do it. He was going to do it, I swear.
How much does this lower it, by the way? 25%. This is robbery. Throw dollar bills at him. You're rich. I really don't want to pay this bribe. But I feel like I kind of have to. Like, look, I'm a judge who's barely getting paid. I'll take my chances. Case subject, damaged lawsuit filed by Brooklyn Troys against the multinational company that develops and sells Loople consumer electronics. Burnt battery of Loople brand phone that belongs to the plaintiff. Defendant is Loople and plaintiff is Brooklyn. Details, recently a person named Brooklyn Troys purchased a mobile phone from the dealer of the Loople company. He claimed that during that period of use, his phone was not charged with an adapter other than its own charger. While using the phone while it was charging, the battery inside it exploded and caused physical damage around the right hand and face of Brooklyn Troyes. Your face looks pretty normal to me, man. You know, you could have, like, wore some bandages and really, like, phoned it up, you know? Brooklyn Troyes, who reported the situation to the Lupul Authority authorized service, did not receive the response he expected and filed a lawsuit for compensation for $500,000. Okay, well, at least it's not like $1 billion, you know, like the other guys. Brooklyn Troyes, exactly 2 months ago and 13 days, 2 months and 13 days ago, I went to the Lupul Dealer Company near my house to buy a phone. I bought a model I liked and started using the phone. During this time, while using the phone, I never charged it with anything other than the charger that came in the box. While I was charging the phone, its battery suddenly exploded, and in addition to the damage of my hand, parts of the phone also hit my face. Afterwards, I called the company, authorized service, and explained the situation and expected at least an apology. But it was not what I expected. They told me that this was a user error and hung up the phone on me. So I filed the lawsuit and demand my rights. Mika Bell, we definitely do not hold ourselves responsible for the incident. Our products have been subjugated to dozens of tests, at least 12. And our engineers have reported that it is not possible to give such a reaction when charged with the current adapter or a powerful adapter. We believe this incident occurred as a result of a transaction that the consumer did not report and is an action designed to tarnish our brand. Evidence. Phone conversation between Brooklyn Troyes and the customer advisor Lupul authorized service. I'm Tiffany. Can I ask for your name so I can help you better? Brooklyn Troyes. My name is Brooklyn Troyes. The phone that I bought for your dealer about 2.5 months ago exploded in my hand. Can you explain how this happened? I'm sorry. Did you say the battery exploded? Yes. Even though I only used the adapter and charging cable that it came in the box. That's not possible. I think it's your fault. It cannot be from us. Is there anything else I can do for you? What a psychotic company. What do you mean it's not possible? It happened. Am I lying? Unfortunately, I can't help you. Have a nice day. I mean, Lupul Company, are you freaking stupid? I stated that you're responsible for the incident. What do you think? I cannot agree with them on this. I explained to them in detail how the incident happened and what I went through. They didn't even take my explanation into consideration. Brooklyn Troyes stated in the statement that you did not take him into consideration. Do you think this is the case? No, Your Honor. We are a reputable company with high customer satisfaction. We didn't think his statements were true because we put our products through dozens of tests. We stated that such an incident can only be due to customer error. I mean, yeah, they're guilty. They're bad. Freaking. There is no evidence that says otherwise. Was found right, and the compensation of $500,000 was paid. Was found right, and the money for the phone. Why would I do this? Was found right, and the money for the phone. And he gets his money back. Yeah. He suffered damages. Don't get assassinated. Don't get arrested. Okay. We're doing good. The family hasn't requested anything recently. For good reason. They know that I won't actually help them. It's just, we don't need to gamble. Yeah, we're doing good. I'm a solid police officer. But I do have to play this funny mini game in order to get into my own suitcase. I don't know why I keep... It's like the same puzzle, too, every time. Ah, it's this guy again. I've arrested two assassins that do the same rose. This guy's good. He's got a lot of copycats. He's got a criminal record. He's not insane. Victim named Jeremy Alder and Mike Byrne were found dead in their
prisons, your wife is the assassin. At this point, I'm thinking I might be the assassin.
I mean, like, at this point, everybody that I've let go,
nobody has been let go from this assassination case. I've arrested both people, even though I don't think I should be, because there's no evidence. Victims named Jeremy Alder and Mike Byrne were found dead in their prison rooms. Those were the guys before it was determined that the security cameras on the floor were the incident. Brad Cold, who stayed. I mean, there's going to be no evidence. Like, right? That's what I'm going to read here. There's no evidence. I only spent 2 days with them. I didn't have any problems or fights like me. They spoke very little. How would I want to, why would I want to kill them? If I were to do this, I wouldn't be in a cell where there is room, making me a suspect. I have paid and I'm paying the penalty for my crimes. I'm not guilty in the incident. The reason I'm here is theft. I've never killed anyone in my life. Yeah, this just feels like a... This feels like the overall speaking case, and there's no... Strangulation rope found on the bodies confirmed to be a murder weapon. A rope? Yeah, this guy's not guilty. He's not guilty.
Thousand banana bucks. Sweet, sweet banana bucks.
And I didn't get arrested.
Please, give me that. Give me the money. Give me this money. Yes. Yes.
Now what is it now? Oh my god!
Your wife wants a smartphone, or your daughter wants a smartphone from you as a birthday gift. The price is $700. Do you accept? Your sanity will drop if you don't accept this. I am about to get assassinated if I don't pay someone off. I'll take my chances going crazy. You ungrateful children. You all just want from me. You just take and take. I'm going to the casino. No, I could go to the casino, but I think I want to pay off at least one. I want to pay off being arrested. 750. There, we're hovering at the 50%. What is that? What's these wrinkly raisin people doing here? What the heck is this case? The tenant agreement. Tennessee agreement. The Tennessee agreement. Okay. Sally John Morgan sues his tenant Daisy to evict her for not paying her rent on time. Legal actions have been taken against Daisy Taylor and Sally J. Morgan for being 3 months late with her rent. The host, Sally J. Morgan, says that the tenant is in breach of the Tennessee agreement. The host demands that the tenant vacate the property and pay the debts owed. My tenant has not paid me a single penny for 3 whole months, even though I warned her many times because I got nothing better to do. She keeps stalling, as if there was not enough. As if this were not enough, they constantly bring their friends to the house and make noise that disturbs the neighbors. I brought my neighbor, who lives downstairs, as a witness, so that you can believe me on this matter. Witness, whatever Morgan says is true. That sounds like he has a gun to his back. Whatever this man says is true. It is true that I have not been able to pay the landlord for a while, but I had to quit my job and I can't afford to pay right now. I told him that it was not an arbitrary situation, that I would pay him when I received my unemployment benefit. However, he is trying to get me kicked out of the house somehow. It's a complete lie that we make too much noise with my friends since my... Okay, well, you might not be making noise, but it sounds like you still haven't paid in 3 months. Mr. Morgan, is it true that Charles Goodman, your downstairs neighbor, whom you call a witness, is your tenant? It's true, Your Honor, but I don't understand its relevancy. Well, it sounds like you could basically be bribing him. It is true that your upstairs neighbor and her friends make so much noise that they disturb you. Sound? Noise? Oh, yes, I remember. Normandy Coasts. The voices are echoing. You brought an insane man? You brought a man. Like, he's either crazy or he's got a ton of PTSD. He's like, he's trailing off with the S's. Smell of gunpowder and the sound of bullet casings. AC. Ashu. Would you please answer the question, Mr. Goodman? Whatever Mr. Morgan says is true. Ms. Taylor, you said your statement that your landlord tried to get you evicted. Why do you think that? He's trying to evict me and raise the rent. But he can't do this because we have a contract. Normally, I would never miss my rent, but this is getting... This getting fired thing was unfortunate for me. This played into his hands. Yeah. Okay. That's a cold case, right? To vacate the house and pay the remaining. She finds a new house and her debts are postponed. Yeah. It's a scam. And the landlord gets what the landlord gets. Man, I thought I was going to walk in and they were going to be like, oh, we need $200 billion worth of things. Can I not get another drink? Thank God. $60. How much does this help? 15%? I'd rather go crazy. Take my chances. Bill passed. Immigrants who commit crime will now be deported. It's starting to feel like Papers, Please more and more. Are you? Oh, you're not an immigrant. Okay. Hang on while I fiddle with this box for way too long. Actually, you know what? I think I'm gonna end that there. This game is interesting. This game gives me a lot of, like, Papers, Please vibes, but it could use a little tweakage. A very interesting game, but I don't know why it needs mini games to, like, open up the case, you know, the open up the file for the evidence. I think it would make more sense if it pertained specifically to, like, the anarchist case. Or, like, the assassinations. But, yeah, the fact that it's just like, oh, a traffic stop. And it's like, why do I have to open this box? It's just like a means to slow you down. Which, of course, really, really sucks. But overall, I would say, you know, for being an indie title, I'm assuming probably made by a pretty small team, if not, you know, who knows, maybe like one guy or something. Again, it's not a bad game. Definitely worth checking out, I guess, if you're looking for a good, like, Papers, Please equivalent. But overall, yeah. It was a pretty solid game, if I say so myself, but could use some tweaks. But that is all the time that I do have. So hopefully, if you enjoyed the stream, feel free to leave a follow. And of course, if you want to do suggestions, I'm always willing to take them if you swing by the Discord. I'm always down to play any sort of game. I know we were getting... Lion Teamers was suggesting I do the Fortnite event. I don't know if we'll do that, as I've never played it a day in my life. But, you know, hey. Suggestions are suggestions. And they're always appreciated. But, yeah. Any support's good support. It always helps out the channel. But I will be on tomorrow. I'm usually on Monday through Friday, 5 p.m. to around 8 p.m. EST. This one, you know, we're ending a little early, you know, a couple minutes. But overall, yeah, it's been a blast. Hopefully there'll be an even better one tomorrow. Hope to see you all there. I'll see you then.